What's going on, y'all? It's DG back with another video. Today, I wanted to go more in depth on the new Anthony Edwards 1. I did have a chance to get both colorways and I have played in both. I obviously played in this one the most because it came out first. One of my most frequently asked questions is how this shoe is, how does it perform, is it worth the money? So I wanted to make a separate video again to just go over my thoughts. Starting with the traction is very good overall, even on dusty courts. It does pick up a considerable amount of dust, and honestly, it doesn't affect it that much. I did find myself still having great grip. The issue with the traction itself is that it's not too durable. So I don't necessarily recommend this shoe for outdoors in terms of outsole durability, but on indoor courts, these are very good. But again, I'm going to emphasize that this is not the most durable traction of all time because my rubber on the outsoles for both shoes are already fraying. From a pure performance perspective, these are very good in terms of traction, has great bite, great squeak, everything that you would want out of a traction setup, this has. I'm not gonna say it's the best traction of all time, obviously, but this is still very, very good. From a performance perspective and playing perspective overall, this cushion is very good as well. It's more subdued in the forefoot for that extra court feel, but in the back, you can definitely feel compression. It's very smooth, very nice overall. This cushion setup is great for big guys as well who move a little bit faster. This cushion setup is very versatile, I promise you. Very good for all positions. And honestly, big men will like these too. Guards will like these for obvious reasons because it has court feel and still is very comfortable, but big men as well will like these too. In terms of sizing is where it gets a little bit tricky. I would say to stay true to size at the end of the day. The shoe fits slightly long, but I don't think it's long enough to go down half size unless you have a very skinny narrow foot or just like very one-to-one fits. I did stay true to size and I felt absolutely no problems with the fit overall, so that's what I would recommend personally. Do have a wide foot, but honestly, I would just stay true to size. A lot of people don't have the chance to buy these in stores or actually try them on. I know I didn't. I've never seen these at my local malls as well, but honestly, I would recommend going true to size. Unless you're very narrow, that's where you go down half a size. The main highlight to this shoe is the support. So you guys see that kind of fake carbon fiber in the back. It really does keep you locked into the heel. So the heel counter is very good. Overall shoe is obviously just visually supportive. You guys see that material all over the upper and it really does keep you contained. Great for step backs, great for any, you know, lateral movement as well. Lockdown is also very good in this shoe, so I highly recommend these if you have any, you know, ankle problems or just like any foot issues. Support is also very good for wide and flat feet like myself. This does not have a pronounced arch in the shoe, so all my, you know, flat footers know what I'm talking about. Some shoes just have a very high arch and it's just very uncomfortable, but these are very good for wide and flat feet. So obviously if you're that foot shape, then just stay true to size again. But the overall support and lockdown is very, very good in this shoe. I had absolutely no issues, you know, playing in these along with the great traction setup, as well as the cushion. It's just very good. In addition to the durability of the outsole, I would say the other downside to the shoe is the weight. Definitely is not the lightest shoe in the world, okay? So if you're looking to fly or if you're looking to like run really, really fast, then I would not recommend this shoe. Now, can you fly? Can you move really, really fast in the shoe? Absolutely yes. That's dependent on you at the end of the day, not the shoe. But if you want the lightest shoe in the world, again, this is not it. I would say it's a little bit heavier than what I'm personally used to. But honestly, for me personally, I don't necessarily mind because I play in so many shoes that I'm used to shoes feeling like this. The downside of the weight is that it's heavy, right? But the upsides to the weight is that it anchors you to the floor. It feels a little bit more substantial and again, provides great support. It is somewhat bottom heavy, so that's why it feels a little bit heavy on foot, along with the huge support materials on the upper. But if you're someone who has very strong legs and you don't necessarily care about weight that much, then I honestly would recommend this shoe to you. If you're looking for the lightest shoe in the world, try the Kobe 8 Pro Trail, any type of Kobe, or just like any low top basketball shoe on Nike. These are pretty similar to the Harden Volume 7 in terms of weight. So I would just like relay those two if you have the Harden Volume 7 and just think about, you know, how those play versus how these play. Another downside to this shoe is that it does scuff a lot on the midsole where the rubber is. For me personally, that's not too big of a deal, but for someone who has a tight budget and really wants one basketball shoe, that may be an issue for you. It just scuffs really easily, but at the end of the day, you're playing basketball, so it's not gonna matter that much, nor are people really looking at that. I did wanna call out the scuffing on the rubber just for people who, you know, are looking to purchase the shoe. So to recap so far, the downsides to this shoe are the weight, the scuffing on the rubber, as well as the durability of the outsole. Positives to this shoe are the elite support features, the great traction performance, and the cushion. Another positive to this shoe is the presentation and packaging. So you guys see two different colored boxes, but it's basically a slide-out box, which is amazing for a shoe that only costs $120. Which leads me to my next positive about this shoe, is that it only costs $120. So for a shoe that looks like this, it comes with extra laces. You guys can see I put in those white speckled ones right here. For only $120, that is an amazing deal in my opinion. You really can't go wrong, especially with the performance features. For those reasons, so performance, aesthetics, as well as the overall packaging and presentation, I do think that this is the best first signature basketball shoe in the market right now. Not to mention the player Anthony Edwards is and is becoming. He is a superstar in this league. His talent is off the charts. He just needs to go to a better market, honestly, because Timberwolves, although they're the number one seed, they haven't been too relevant on, you know, every platform on social media, nor, you know, the national spotlight. So if he goes to a bigger market, he will definitely be, you know, the biggest star in the NBA. His first signature shoe is money, guys. I promise you, I highly recommend this shoe performance-wise, unless you don't like somewhat heavy shoes or you just don't have strong legs, then I would recommend staying away from this product. But honestly, if you are a hooper who needs a supportive shoe, who needs a comfortable shoe, who needs a great looking shoe that's finally looking different than everything else on the market, then I highly recommend these. Leave a comment down below letting me know which one is your favorite. Do you like the first colorway better? Do you like the second colorway, new wave colorway better? I know there's an all-star colorway coming out soon, so I can't wait to get those in. There's been so many leaks. Again, I'll be covering every single AE1 colorway on this channel, so make sure to subscribe. Leave a comment down below letting me know your experience in the AE1, how you're playing in them, how you're liking them. Are you getting buckets in them? Do you dislike them? I want to hear your opinions. Leave a comment down below and let me know. Follow me on all socials at DG Hoops, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.